Hello, Chilin. Yes, what we have learned in the previous classes about the different types of systems that works in our body, isn't it, Chilin? So we have already learned about the internal organs, external organs, and you know what the external organs will do. And now we are going to study about the internal organs. Already in the previous classes, we have learned about the respiratory system, isn't it, that belongs to the lungs. Okay, how the lungs functions, what is the work of the lungs, okay, and what does it do, we have learned. And coming to the next system, that is called the circulatory system. The circulatory system, we have learned that about how the heart functions and what is the work of the heart, isn't it, and how the blood is purified, isn't it? And next, coming to the other system, that is called the skeletal system, and how the bone work is framed in our body, what does the bones do, and how it supports the body, we have learned, isn't it? Now coming to the very interesting topic, that is called the digestive system. What is it called, children? Digestive system. Can you see on the screen, children, the digestive system? See, the person is standing there, and a pink color part that means from the throat to the stomach, full intestines, that all works. How does it work? What is the process? Okay, what is the process? What is the work of the each organ? Okay, and what, how does it work? How the food gets digested in our body? So this is called the digestive system. See, daily we are taking food, children, morning, afternoon, evening. What is happening inside that food? Okay, how it is getting digested? What is the work of the digestive system? We are drinking water, we are drinking milk. Where it is going? What is happening? Isn't it? So how it is getting digested? How we are getting energy? How it is converted into blood? Okay, with the blood only, the food gets digested and turns into blood. I already said, isn't it, children? So how it is digested and how it is becoming as a soft and how it is turned into a blood. These all we are going to learn in the digestive system. It is very interesting, children. Please concentrate. Earlier, we used to have a good lab in the class. So in the class, I used to show all the organs, internal organs, but it is difficult to show you now, but I'm trying to show you each and every organ, children. So please concentrate. Okay, let's go. Listen carefully about the this topic. Okay, now see, we are drinking water. You see, the boy is drinking the water from through where he is drinking, with the help of the mouth. Okay, where it is going? It is going entering into the neck, okay, throat. And where it is going directly, this all we are going to learn. Here, generally you might have observed that the size of our stomach increases when we drink water or eat food. Isn't it? That is obviously, no, children. When we feel hungry, our stomach goes inside. When you take any food, if you eat so much of food, immediately what happens? Your stomach blows. Isn't it? It increases in its size. Okay, it increases in its size with the water and also the food. Okay, you see, when you don't eat any food, your stomach goes inside. When you eat something, your stomach will increase. So what is happening? Where this food is going? Why it is happening? Let us learn in detail. So what are the here digestive system things? Okay, what are the organs here? Can you see, children, from mouth to down, many organs are there. Why these all organs are important? Are they all working for the digestive, the food to get the digest, isn't it? So here, when we compare the digestive system of other organisms, the human digestive system is very complex, and different parts perform different functions by using various digestive juices and enzymes. See, children, it is, what is the meaning of your digestive juices and enzymes? Our body is having many digestive juices. Okay, compared to the other organisms, the human digestive system is very complex. Different parts here, that what are the different parts? Can you see, children, on the screen? From mouth to the stomach, it is connected. and how it is digested. Okay, how the food is entering our body and how it is digested, how it is turning into a blood. It is very complex. And how the different parts are helping it and how the different organisms are helpful to digest the food. What are the digestive juices? What are the enzymes? This all we are going to learn in this topic. Okay, now next go to the children, when if you were in the class, we used to have a lab. In the lab, we are having all the digestive system and internal organs in the lab. I used to show, but it is not possible now. But I'm trying to show you on the screen the different organs, and I'll show you the separately also each organ. Okay, now see the pink on the screen. Can you see, children, the pink color food? Can you see the food? It is clearly given, children. If you want, I'll little enlarge also. You can see, okay, the food. Okay, the food is near to the mouth. The person, if the person swallow a food, where it enters? It enters the mouth. What is the next step? With the teeth, we chew. Okay, and with the help of the saliva. Just all of you hold your mouth for some time. Just a second, 2 seconds. What is forming in your mouth? A liquid substance. What is that called? Saliva. What is it called, children? Saliva. See, with the help of the saliva, our food is becoming soft. Isn't it? When it is soft, where it enters? It is enter into the buccal cavity. Can you see the buccal cavity on the screen, children? Yes. And next, it enters the pharynx. See, the tight thing, it is there, no, in your, all of you put a finger on your throat. See, some hard substance is touching, no? What is that called? That is called a pharynx. Beside the pharynx, you have the esophagus. What it is called, children? Esophagus. We can call it as a food pipe also. What we can call esophagus is called also as a food pipe. Here, near the pharynx, it is divided into two. One is, I showed you, no, in the lungs, how the air enters. That is windpipe, and this is called the food pipe. Two pipes will be having in your throat. Okay, so through the esophagus, food enters. Okay, and now can you see the liver? Near the liver, they will have some digestive juices. Okay, that it will release, and it will enter the gallbladder. Okay, it will enter the gallbladder, and in the gallbladder, and again, it enters to the stomach. In the stomach, there are many digestive juices. Okay, there are many digestive juices. There it further mixes. And first, I am showing only the parts. Okay, and stomach. And can you see the large intestine? Yes, the outer part is called the large intestine. And inner is... And two color substance... That is called... pancreases. What it is called? Pancreases. It releases the pancreatic juice that helps in the digestive process. And next is the rectum. Rectum, where the undigested food comes into the rectum. And next is the anus. What is the next is called anus. So these are the organs of the digestive system. It helps. Okay. Now, the image on the screen shows the path of the chewed food. Okay. Now, next, coming to the digestive system. See, where the food first enters, it is entering into the mouth. Okay. See, can you see the clearly on the screen? The food enters, you take an apple or any food. It enters into the mouth. It is chewed with the teeth. Okay. Food we eat is chewed by our teeth in the mouth. Next. Next is how the food is chewed. Okay. It is chewed with the help of the teeth, and it further mixes on the tongue. The tongue helps in mixing the food and forwarding it to the next part of the lower jaw, and also helps in the whole process. Okay, so it further mixes up with the saliva. Okay, with the help of the saliva, it enters to the where it enters. It enters to the see. Can you see here clearly, children? Where it enters, the soft food that is mixed with saliva passes through the esophagus. Can you see the food pipe here to the stomach? Yes. This is here two layers. I said no. This is one tube. This is another tube. This is the windpipe. This is a food pipe. Two pipes will be having. Food will enter through one pipe, and also the wind will enter, the air will enter the another pipe. Okay, so this, the food is entering into the esophagus. That esophagus is also called as a food pipe. It is called as food pipe. Now, what is the next process? The next process is the stomach, where it enters through the stomach with the help of the liver. No, it is not connected. It is only connected with the help of the little juices. It goes into the stomach. Where it goes, children? It goes into the stomach. Can you see the stomach? Yes. See the small food particles, the blue color particles, what is they called? Pepsin. Okay, and here the, all the green color substance is called, that is called the digestive juice. What is it called? The digestive juice. Can you see on the screen to the left side, children? This is the stomach. And this is the shape of the stomach. Okay. It is entering into the stomach. In the stomach, when it enters, it is mixed with the gastric juices. What it will mix with, children? Gastric juice. Juice means it is a liquid form. Can you can understand? No. It is a liquid form. In the stomach, the food gets digested by the action of some enzymes and acids. In the gastric juice, we'll have the, all the enzymes and the acids. Here, the food is chyme. Okay. That means it becomes very, very soft. And in the next picture, you can see the sphincters and also the small intestine. After the food, where it is going, it is entering into the small intestine. See, where can you see the left side also? After the food get digested, where it is entering, children? It is entering into the small intestine. You can see on the left side of the figure also, it is entering from the first mouth, then food pipe. Okay, then it is entering into the stomach. It is mixed up with the digestive juices. After the mixed up with the digestive juices, when it becomes very soft and soft chyme, and where it is entering? It is entering into the small intestine. You can see the small intestine in the left side of the picture. Okay, the small intestine is the longest part of the alimentary canal. Here, the complete digestion of carbohydrates, proteins, okay, and fats takes place. Okay, here all the, and we have learned now about the things which are important to our body, like carbohydrates, they are released here. The fats takes place. Okay, then in the next picture, what it is happening in the stomach, small intestine, it is mixed up with the all the juices. With the help of the small intestine, the maximum amount of digested food is sent to various parts through the blood, okay, of the body to the blood. Yes, here it returns into the blood. In the small intestine, it turns into the blood and we supply to all parts of the body. So that is, we are getting the energy from small intestine. Okay, can you see with the different enzymes, blue color, red color, yellow color? Okay, these all are the several enzymes. Okay, now what is the next thing? Here is a large intestine. From the small intestine, almost the food gets digested. The unwanted food, where it is there, no, that is sent to the large intestine. This is called the large intestine, children. So almost when it is turned, it is sent to the remaining amount of the food material passes to the large intestine. What the large intestine work? The rest of the amount is sent to the large intestine. What does it do? Yes, it in the large intestine, the remaining amount of the food material passes to the large intestine and it is gets further digested. What it will do, children? It is again it digests, and the large intestine reabsorbs the maximum amount of water from the remaining food material. So the in the large intestine, it takes lot of water, children. It takes lot of water, and other food is also mixed up with the water. It takes most of the amount. Okay, and it what it will do again? It will send to, see, can you send the other unwanted food is sent to the rectum. See that the food, you can see, you know, that place is called the rectum, and the material is then passed through the anus, which is the last part of the digestive part. Anus means, see, morning you will go, no, motion, yes, feces. So that is the unwanted food, and unwanted water, how it is getting, it is sent to the kidneys. Their kidneys purified and you go as a urine. Okay, you can see so clearly, children, how it is coming down. Okay, then now see how we'll get the material is then passed through the anus, which is the last part of the digestive path. It comes through the digestive path. And before going to how this food digested, how this all is happening, who invented, children? Yes, who invented? This is a interesting topic. Here, there is a past one story I want to tell you. I will show you on the screen. Here, can you see the, who is this man? He's a scientist. Okay, he's a scientist. And can you see the right side picture, children? Here is a scientist and one more patient. See what he's doing side, he's having some bulb. Actually, this person's name is Martin. He is a soldier. He is 18 years old soldier. But what happens, you know, he get a hurt in the battlefield. So immediately this doctor will, he's a, called a doctor and scientist, he goes to this person. So he treats him and he has a very good injury in his stomach. Okay, he treats him after 1.5 years. It will be healed. And but what happened in that where he got a shot, there all layer of it will be appeared on his stomach. Small layer, transparent layer, so that he could see what is there in the stomach. Okay, the doctor can see that through that layer, means small, what is, suppose in your stomach, children, you get a wound. If there, the skin is not there, only one layer is formed. You see everything in, into that, no? Yes, like that only, the Bhimon doctor could see everything in his stomach, what it is happening. He saw the liquid form in the stomach. Here, historical evidence of human digestion. Dr. Bhimon's experiments revolutionized the concepts on digestion. June 16, 1822 has become the beginning for the various pioneering experiments in the medicine. How? Because of the Dr. Bhimon's. Okay, Dr. Bhimon. Now, next, can we go to the second picture, children? The how the evidence. Dr. Bhimon's experiments revolutionized the concepts on digestion. What he did on June 16, from the beginning of various pioneering experiments in the medicine, he narrated many of his discoveries in his journal, which says, "I consider myself but a humble with the experimenter." Okay, what he did, you know, with the help of the pipe, he removed some of the digestive juices from the Martin's stomach. Okay, and he experimented. Some of the discoveries of the Dr. Bhimon's on digestion of food were, he found that temperature of the stomach during the digestion remains unchanged. 100 Fahrenheit by 38 degrees Celsius. He found that pure gastric juices contains large amounts of HCl. That means, children, in the stomach, the food gets digested very fast. Why? Because in the stomach, there is a temperature. What is there, children? The temperature will be there. In the temperature, you can... In the temperature, you can see how the food gets digested in the stomach. At the same time, if you keep the same food outside, what happens? If you mix the digestive juices outside, what happens? What happens? Can you tell me? Might be what the Dr. Bhimon has experimented. We will see in the next picture. See, we can see through the Martin's stomach, what the juices were there. Okay. And how the gastric juices are working. Okay. If there is no gastric juices, if there is no mouth, if it does not enter into the pharynx, what is happen? What will happen? He has discovered. Now you see, he found that gastric juice is secreted immediately when the food enters the stomach, which helps digestion. Digestion begins immediately when the food enters the stomach. See, before only the digestive juices will be not there, children. When the food enters the stomach only, before that only, the stomach collects all the digestive juices. Okay, when it collects the digestive juices, what is happening? Here there is a story. We will learn in the textbook. He found that food in the stomach fulfills the hunger, even if it do not pass through the mouth and the esophagus. Whatever it is there, children, if you put the food directly into the stomach, it gets digested. It's no need to mix up with the saliva or esophagus or anyway. But what is the difference? That also we can find out. See, it is so interesting, children. See, suppose what the Beaumont has said, you know, suppose he took the digestive juices from the Martin's stomach. Okay, the juice will be there, no? He removed with the help of the pipe and he put into a jar. Okay, he collected some of the digestive juices from the Martin's stomach and he put into a jar. And same food he has given. Suppose, example, you can see the food item. Unboiled milk he gave to the Martin. So in the stomach directly, it because he can see, no, it was transferring, no, in the stomach. He can see that 2 hours, 15 minutes, the unboiled milk got digested in the stomach. In the jar, glass jar, it took 4 hours, 45 minutes. How much time it took in the jar, children? Same boiled milk, it took 4 hours, 45 minutes. And after the next day, he gave boiled milk to the Martin. Directly, he took from the mouth, it went into the food pipe, and again, it enters the stomach. So in the stomach, it took, boiled milk took 2 hours. And the same digestive juice he put in the jar, it took 4 hours, 15 minutes. And next day, he gave the boiled eggs. Boiled eggs took 3 hours, 13 minutes in the Martin's stomach. But in the glass jar, it took 8 hours. Half boiled eggs he gave to the Martin, he ate, and it took 3 hours to digest. Fourth point, again in the glass jar, it took half boiled egg, took children 76 hours and 30 minutes. Here only 3 hours, there 76 hours. See why the difference? The same boiled boiled milk completely boiled, it took 3 hours. Okay, boiled eggs took, half boiled eggs, skimmed egg, 2 hours. Okay, and here it took 4 hours, 15 minutes in the jar. Why, children? And unboiled egg, complete unboiled, took 1 hour, 30 minutes, and here it took 4 hours. That means what you understand from these experiments? See, the table on the screen gives information about Dr. Beaumont's observation on the digestion of food items. So, the boiled or unboiled. See, unboiled egg took very less time, isn't it? Even in the glass jar or even in the stomach also, because it is a liquid form. Okay, now understood, children, what is the difference? Yes. Now, coming to the next. Suppose if you take what happens when we eat an apple. See, just you took a bite of apple. What happening? It enters the mouth. It enters the esophagus. It is chewed and it is formed into the soft manner. Again, it formed into a more soft manner. It formed into a more soft manner. Again, it converts into the blood. The waste comes out. Okay, the waste is like this when it is completely chewed. Can you see the graph, children? How it is going? Okay, now here, next. Digestive system take apple is cut into pieces and chewed. It mixes with the mouth, with the saliva in the mouth. For this, the time is taken 5 to 30 seconds. How many time will take, children? Only 30 seconds. Esophagus carries the food into the stomach. For this, the time taken is 10 to 15 seconds in the stomach. The esophagus carries the food to the stomach, no? Food pipe? Yes. How much time? 10 to 15 seconds. The food in the stomach mixes with the digestive juices and made into small pieces. For this, the stomach takes 3 to 5 hours. How much time takes, children? 3 to 5 hours it takes to get that digested. Because it should make into a small, tiny parts, isn't it? with the help of the small digestive juices. And in the intestine, in the small intestine, the food is completely converted into liquid form and is mixed with the blood. How it is mixed, children? It is mixed with the blood. For this purpose, food stays for 3 to 4 hours in the small intestine. How many hours it takes, children? 3 to 4 hours. Okay, are you understanding, children? See, can you see the picture on the left side of the screen? Yes, from in the food, it takes, in the stomach, it takes, again, 3 to 4 hours. Again, small intestine, 3 to 4 hours. Okay, now, the food that is made into very minute particles is transported to all parts of the body after mixing with the blood. Yes, it is. It will be mixed with the blood and it is transported to all parts of the body so that only we'll get the energy. Are you understanding, children? Is it clear? And one more thing, the food that is made into very minute particles, it's transported to all parts of the body after mixing with the blood. The undigested food, where it goes? Yes. Again, that remaining food will be with the help of the water, it enters to the large intestine. Where it will enter? Large intestine. Here, the water and other fluids are absorbed into the blood. Okay, children, the food stays for 8 hours to 3 days in the large intestine. How many hours it stays, children? It depends upon the digestion. If you are very active, then your food gets digested very fast. If you are very blunt, if you don't do any exercises, it takes nearly 3 days to be in the large intestine. And how the unwanted wastes will come out? The unwanted wastes in liquid form are sent out in the form of urine. So it is mixed up with the what I'm saying, it mixes with the water and the food, no, in the large intestine. So unwanted food, where it will send to the kidneys. That kidneys will purify that and it, the other wastes will be sent through the urine. And what about the undigested food? The unwanted wastes in the solid form are sent out through the anus, feces. I said no motion. In the form of motion, it will come out every day. So that's why going to motion is very, very important every day, children. Then only the digestive system is perfect. Okay. So this is the process of the digestion of the food, children. Now, here the food that is made into very minute particles is transported to small all parts of the body after mixing with the blood. I said no. The unwanted water will come as a urine and the unwanted waste of the food comes out as a feces. Okay. It comes as a feces through the anus. So if the wastes are sent out easily from the digestive tract, if we drink enough water or eat rotten fruits like citrus fruits, etc. See, children, eating food is not important. At the same time, you have to drink plenty of water also. You have to drink plenty of water and also you have to eat the fruity vegetables like which contain citrus like guava, orange, watermelon, banana, okay. Oranges. These are very, very important too. So that's what all the doctors, parents will say after eating the food, surely you have to eat fruit. That makes your digestion very fast. Okay, children. Now, here is on the screen, I am giving the picture image of the digestive system. See, I showed you already. So please find out what are these organs. Okay, the organs are there. Take time, draw in a rough paper. Okay, I'll tell you to draw in the classwork also. But here, take a rough paper and what is what here, the options are given on the side. The first one is mouth, as you know, the first one is a mouth. And what is the second one? What is the third one? The arrow marks are given. There you can write water. First, find out what are these organs. Okay. Then analyze how the food will go and what it is happening in your stomach. See, not only your stomach, my stomach, everybody's stomach, same parts will be there. And the same process will be there in all the human beings. Okay, children. And when you go to the butcher shop, you can see the digestive system of the goat. Okay. Sometimes, when you are finding time, sometimes you go with your parents, no? There you identify how the two, almost same in the goat and us, almost same. What are the parts there? You can see easily. Okay, children? Now let's go into the textbook. The digestive system, where does the chewed food and the swallowed food go? You might have observed that our stomach seems to be bulged when we drink water or eat food. In the picture given below, the path of the chewed food and the water drunken is shown. The food we eat changes its form in our mouth. The food supplied to the different parts of the body is not in the same form as we eat. So if you are eating apple, apple is coming out? No. What it is happening? Okay, the food supplied from the different parts of the body is not in the same form as we eat. It changes to different forms. The solid and the liquid food changes into simple substance and finally get absorbed into the blood. This process of changing starts from the mouth. The absorbed food is utilized by the body and the remaining waste materials are sent out of the body in the form of feces and urine. See, children, so clearly I explained everything, children, even in the textbook. I showed each picture, how the food is entering, how it is coming out, and how it is get digested with the digestive juices. What is the work of the pancreas? What is the work of the small intestine? What is the work of the esophagus? Everything I have explained. Okay, now window of the stomach. Dr. Beaumont's experiment. I thought, you know, in 1882, Dr. Beaumont had to treat a soldier named Martin who was injured by a bullet in the stomach. Martin was 18 years old at the time. Martin was healthy before the injury. Dr. Beaumont dressed the wound and treated him. The wound healed after 1.5 years. But there appeared a large hole in the stomach. I said, no, there appeared a large hole in the stomach. The aperture was covered by the loose layer of skin. I said, no, we have the 7 layers on the skin, children. But that layer was only covered with a single one. So that Dr. Beaumont could see full what is there in the stomach. What are the parts in the stomach? In which year? 1822. So we could look into the stomach by pressing this layer. The doctor not only used to look into the stomach through this hole, but also used to take out the fluid from the stomach with the help of a tube. I showed you in the picture, no children, just now? Yes, he used to take the fluid from the stomach. With this, the doctor got an opportunity for this experiment. What he did, he got an opportunity for these experiments. So Dr. Beaumont experimented on Martin's stomach for about 9 years. How many years, children? 9 years he experimented. And what all experimented, I showed you in the table now. He used unboiled milk. He took fluids in the jar. And why it is getting soon digested in the stomach? Because of the temperature. So because of the temperature in the body, it is getting fast digestion. But if the same digestive food, here also in the jar also used to get the digested, but it used to take a time. Are you getting my point? It used to get a time, take a time. Now, at this time, scientists did not know how food got digested. How do the digestive juices in the stomach helps in the digestion? Do they just soften the food and associated with this process? Are they helpful in any other way? No one knew. There was any other organs? So many doubts were there. Dr. Beaumont took out a small quantity of fluid from Martin's stomach and put into a glass jar to find out if the food kept in the glass jar digests by itself or does this take the another fluid, bring any changes in the food. He wanted to test this. For this, he performed an experiment. He took a small amount of digestive juices from the Martins with the help of a tube and placed 20 pieces of fish in a glass jar filled with 10 ml of digestive juices at 8:30 a.m. in the morning. So what he did, children, in a glass jar, he took digestive juices from the stomach of Martin and put into the jar 10 ml. And in that, he added tiny pieces of fish. Okay, at what time? 8:30. He kept the glass jar in the same temperature that is maintained by the stomach. So stomach temperature will be 30 degrees Celsius. The same temperature. Then he examined the pieces of fish at 2 o'clock in the afternoon. They had dissolved. Yes, in the digestive, there were no fish pieces. It is dissolved into the digestive juices. Dr. Beaumont did this experiment with the different food items. He used the same food given to the Martin and kept in the glass jar filled with the digestive juices. He gave the Martin food at the same time and put the food into the glass jar kept outside the body. Yes, he gave the same time to the Martin and put into the same time in the jar also. But there was a difference. So what he observed is he compared the time taken by the food to digest. He tabulated his observation. Let us observe the Dr. Beaumont's. Yes, raw milk, 2 hours 15 minutes, 4 hours 45 minutes. Boiled milk, 2 hours, 4 hours 15 minutes in the glass jar. Boiled eggs, 3 hours 13 minutes. It took in the glass jar 8 hours. Half boiled egg, 3 hours in the stomach. And in the glass jar, 76 hours, 30 minutes. And skimmed egg means 2 hours, and in the glass jar 4 hours 15 minutes. And unboiled egg means directly egg, it took only 1 hour 30 minutes in the stomach, but in the glass jar it took 4 hours. Now say, what is the function of our stomach? Dr. Beaumont discovered many secrets of the digestive system by conducting many experiments. He found that food is digested quickly in the stomach. You can underline these, children. He found that food is digested quickly in the stomach than when placed outside the body. Did you observe the same thing in the table given above? Yes. Our stomach churns the food items and digests the food. Beaumont found that when Martin was unhappy, the process of digestion was slow. Here it is very interesting thing, children. When the Martin was very happy, the food used to digest very fast. But when the Martin was unhappy, the process of digestion was very slow. He also found that digestive juices present in the stomach are acidic in nature. They are acidic in nature. It has having the power to burn it. Have you ever heard people complaining of acidity or burning sensation in the stomach or chest region when they do not eat food properly or food is not digested? Yes. When the food is not digested, what is happening? We'll get a stomach pain. Why we are getting stomach pain? And some people will say, the elderly people say, Abba, I'm getting manta, kadupulo manta. My stomach is burning. Why? Because of more releases of the acidity. So we have to eat the food on time, children. Okay, which is suitable to our body. Okay, if the food is not digested, you will get the burns in the stomach. That means called the acidity problem. So thanks to Dr. Beaumont experiments, the process of digestion has been understood. After his experiments, scientists conducted many other experiments without waiting for patients with bullet injury or people with a hole in the stomach. These scientists observed the internal organs using other scientific methods. Yes, so Dr. Beaumont was the first person to experiment this. After that, many scientists have done. They did not wait for the bullet to get, or they did not wait for the, they used to take the digestive juices, and they have done many experiments and have created the new medicines, everything. Okay, children, did you enjoy the story of the Martin? Can we tell this, the story of our stomach? Yes, we can tell. No, what do you say? Yes, it is a very, very interesting subject. What happens in the different parts of the digestive system when we eat a tomato? What happens, children? Yes. What happens? Suppose we have show you for the apple. Here, what happens in the different parts? Tomato is cut into pieces and chewed in the mouth. It mixes with the saliva into the mouth. For this, time taken is 5 to 30 seconds. It carries to the esophagus. Esophagus takes 10 to 15 seconds. And see the third point, the food gets churned into the stomach and mixes with the digestive juices. It is made into small pieces. For this, stomach takes 3 to 5 hours. How much it takes, children, in the stomach? 3 to 5 hours. So that's why we'll have the 3 to 5 hours gap in the breakfast, lunch and dinner. Did you observe, children? Yes. In the small, again from the stomach, where it goes into the small intestine. In the small intestine, the food is completely converted into liquid form. So in the small intestine, the food, you can't see, it is completely turned into liquid form. Okay, see, very liquids. And that mixes with the blood. For this purpose, food stays to 3 to 4 hours in small intestine. 3 to 5 hours in stomach, 3 to 4 hours in small intestine, and what happened? Undigested food and water enters into the large intestine. Water and other fluids are absorbed into the blood here, and the food stays 8 to 3 days in the large intestine. Okay, the food made into very minute particles, and it is transported to all parts of the body after mixing with the blood. From the where it goes into the large intestine, and the leftover food comes as feces. I said, no, children, unwanted wastes in the solid form are sent out to the anus. We should never overeat, and 25 of our stomach should be kept empty. So what I'm telling you, children, so it takes, see, in the stomach, it takes 3 to 4 hours. In the intestine, it takes 3 to 5 hours. Again, it goes, when it goes into the large intestine, it takes 8 hours to 2 days. It is not a high process, children. So from stomach, it goes. So what we have to do is, we should never overeat. You have to put your stomach 25% empty only. Don't fill your stomach fully. Okay, you keep 25% of the stomach empty only. So the wastes are sent out easily from the digestive tract. If we drink enough water, the doctor who treats diseases of digestive system is called gastroenterologist. Okay, the person who treats the stomach diseases is called the gastroenterologist. Okay, children, read the textbook perfectly, the digestive system. See all the organs. Please learn the digestive parts, how it is done. Explain to your parents, explain to your brother, explain to your sister. Okay, so that you will never forget. Understood, children? Is there any doubt? Please go through the lesson of the digestive system. Understand perfectly, see the each organ properly, and try to understand. Okay, children? Bye, take care.